One major thing that a lot of people get wrong on their hair growth journey is they are always chasing products instead of building a good routine. Now, don't get me wrong, products have their work and they are very important, but knowing how and when to use those products effectively, that is the sauce. Unfortunately, many people don't get this, and the few who do go around copying other people's routines, and that is never the best thing to do, because that's how people end up with routines that either don't work or are too stressful, or even both. Imagine doing a routine that is already too stressful and it's not working. Nah. So in this video, I'm going to start from the beginning. I'll teach you what a routine is, why it is important, and how to build one that is tailored especially to you to help you hit all your hair goals. You ready? Let's get it. So, what is your routine? A haircare routine is a set of steps that you follow on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis to tackle a hair problem or to achieve a particular hair goal that you have. For me, I like to define it as what you do on wash day and then everything you do in between wash days. I mean, it's way simpler that way. Also, bear in mind that it is a routine. It's something that you do again and again and again. So it doesn't really have to be super complicated. Just like the definition that I gave, it is what you do on wash day and then what you do between wash day one and wash day two. And then you just keep repeating the cycle over and over and over again. I'll explain more later in this video. So why is it important to have a routine? First up, I'd say guidance. Once you have a routine and you already know what you want to do to your hair, you are not confused about what to do to your hair on a particular day or a particular time of the month or a particular time of the week. It's like having a plan, right? So you're not confused about what you want to do. You already have it planned out, so you can just easily follow it. Then it also helps with consistency. Now, with the guidance that having a routine brings, it is now easy to follow the plan. See, once you have spent that time and effort creating your plan, creating your routine, your guide, following it becomes easier because, again, you're not confused about what you want to do. You already have your plan, you have it laid out, so you can easily follow it day after day, week after week, month after month, and before you know it, you're seeing results. Finally, of course, we have the achievement of the goal that you set out to hit. The entire point of building a routine is you have a goal. So let's say somebody's goal is to deal with breakage so that they can have longer hair. Now you create a routine that helps you to deal with breakage and you follow it consistently. At the end of the day, you will end up defeating this breakage and you'll start seeing those inches, baby. So yeah, very important to get a routine, especially if you actually want to see results in your hair growth journey. Okay, so I've told you what a routine is and I've told you why it's important. So let's get into the main the coco of this video. Let's do what we came into the room to do. So when it comes to building a routine for yourself, there are four things that you need to consider: the goal, the problem, the products and tools needed, and your lifestyle. Let me break this down. Any productivity guru will tell you that before you start making any kind of plan in your life, you need to first set goals. It's the same thing with haircare routines. You need to understand exactly what you are trying to achieve with this haircare routine before you even start building it. Because if the routine comes first, then you might not see the results that you want to see because the routine was not targeting this goal at all in the first place. So before you start building your routine, exactly what are you trying to achieve? Are you trying to achieve healthier hair? Are you trying to achieve longer hair? Are you trying to achieve healthier and longer hair? Are you trying to boost your volume? Are you trying to grow back your edges? Are you trying to grow your hair longer than the shoulder length that it has been for the past 5 years? You need to set your goal. Next comes the problem. Once you have set your goal, you now need to figure out what exactly is holding me back from achieving this goal. What is the problem? So let's say you have been dealing with short hair, like your hair has been at your shoulders since the last time you remember. Every time you do length check, it's stopping here and you are tired. So now you need to think, what could be causing this stagnant growth? A lot of the time it's breakage, dryness, maybe some over manipulation, maybe you're not doing enough protective styles. So once you figure out what the problems are that are hindering you from getting to this goal that you have set for yourself, then you now know exactly what to target in your haircare routine. Next comes the products and the tools needed. For consistency, I'm going to be sticking with this length issue, because I'm sure a lot of people struggle from this. You know, people who have had their hair at the same length for an extended period of time, which really shouldn't be. So that is the example I'll be using as I'm explaining in this video. So we've already said the goal is longer, healthier hair, right? And then what is stopping you from hitting this goal? What is the problem? The problem is breakage, dryness, and over manipulation. Now you need to think, what are the products and tools that I need for me to overcome these issues? So we have breakage, dryness. For dryness, you're going to need a deep conditioner. You're going to need a leave-in conditioner, maybe a hair mist as well. You need probably a shampoo that is conditioning, a shampoo that is surface-free, that will not strip your hair and cause tangles on your wash day. These are now the things that will help you determine exactly what kind of products you want to get. But if you have already gone and bought products and you do not even consider your routine, sure, you see that the link isn't linking, right? Okay, so you think about it. Okay, I might need a heat cap for when I'm deep conditioning so that the moisture from the deep conditioner can penetrate my hair better. These are the things that will help you pick and choose exactly what you need in your own hair care routine. This is why a lot of people will say, don't just follow your faves. Your fave can be using that brush. I will probably put a picture to be brushing my hair, but you know that if you try it, BC, your hair will be all over the floor. Don't be following what everybody's doing. Or do the one that suits you. Now, if your hair is still hard and it's still like in the treatment phase, you might want to just stick to finger detangling or using a white tooth comb. Maybe it's not time for a brush yet. Drop it down. Put it on the floor, BC. So yeah, once you figured out the goal, the problem, then you cannot think of what products and tools you're going to need to mitigate these issues so that you can go closer to your goal. Next thing is, you also need to consider your lifestyle, because not everybody has the time, honey. Most trichologists will tell you that you should wash your hair every 7 to 10 days, but not everybody has got that time, sweetheart. I don't have that time, and I work remotely. Not to talk of somebody who's going to the office every single day, like Monday to Friday, 9 to 5. Who has that time, right? For someone like me now, in my own lifestyle, I don't know about you. If you have the time, go ahead, wash your hair every weekend. See, it is the best thing, it's optimal. I'm not even going to lie to you. I wish I had the time to be washing my hair every weekend, but I just don't. In my own lifestyle, I would put my wash day every 2 weeks. That's the best I can do. Some people like to style their hair, like to, you know, do buns and puffs and things. If you are that kind of person, go ahead. But I would always advise that the styles that you do should last you at least 4 to 7 days. At least, okay? Me, I like to do long-term protective styles. I can have my hair in these cornrows for the entire 2 weeks between my wash day, because like I said, I'm a lazy, I have other things to do than my hair. But some other people, you know, they are more active, their relationship with their hair, they are tight. So if you have the time, you can go ahead and wash your hair every week. What your routine might look like would be, on a Sunday you would wash your hair, do, you know, the shampoo, deep conditioner, leave-in conditioner, all the things, right? And then you put your hair in like a low bun, and then you carry that low bun throughout the week, and then on Sunday again you repeat. You wash your hair, put your hair in another style, and then you carry that style throughout the week, and then on Sunday you repeat again. And that's the routine. You repeat and you repeat and you repeat and you keep going. But for someone like me, I would wash my hair on Sunday and put it in, let's say, cornrows or mini twists, and then, you know, I would carry those mini twists for 2 weeks, and then on my next wash day I would loosen the hair and wash my hair and put my hair in another style and just keep going and keep going and keep going, like that. Do you get what I mean? So it looks different for different people, right? Depending on the kind of hairstyles that you like to do, depending on how often you can make time to wash your hair, to deal with your hair and all that. And like I said earlier in the video, your routine is what you do on wash day and everything you do in between. So yeah, you don't just wash your hair, put your hair in a style, and abandon it for a whole week. Or in my case, abandon it for 2 weeks. Nuh-uh, you don't do that. Because even in a protective style, your hair can still get dry and it can still cause friction and breakage. So every once in a while, depending, like, there's a lot of experimenting to do here. There is no hard and fast. So For me, when I put my hair in a style on, let's say, Sunday, by Wednesday, I would have used maybe a hair mist or I would have sprayed water in my hair just to reintroduce some moisture into my hair after 3 days since my head last touched water. And then maybe I'll oil my scalp again. And then that's all done on a Wednesday. So Thursday, Friday, my hair is good. Saturday, my hair is good. By Sunday, I'll probably re-moisturize my hair again, you know, take it out, go to church. And then on Monday, Tuesday, my hair is still fine. My hair is still good. It's still thriving off the moisture that I put on Sunday. By next Wednesday again, I'm like, my hair is feeling a little bit dry. Let me, you know, put some hair mist, re-moisturize my scalp, you know, do some little things here and there. You know, those little things, they come together to keep your hair soft, keep your hair moisturized. And in that process, it reduces breakage, reduces dryness. So you see how everything is coming together to hit that ultimate goal. The goal is to maintain your hair health and also to retain length so that you can actually see a difference in your hair length. So with protective styles, you are not manipulating your hair every day, or even if you are doing low manipulation styles like low buns or high puffs, as long as you are not combing, detangling, manipulating your hair every single day, you're doing something right. For me, I've noticed that as a lazy person who really doesn't like detangling or dealing with my hair, protective styles, long-term protective styles like cornrows, mini twists, they work better for me. So I would put my hair in cornrows and I would not have to detangle or touch it for the next 2 weeks. All I would need to do is to keep it moisturized and to also keep my scalp moisturized. So I would use either an oil or a scalp spray depending on how I'm feeling, right? And then I would just take care of my scalp and keep my hair moisturized. Just like that, it's growing, it's glowing, my hair is looking really, really good. Those are the things that you really need to consider. How much time you have to dedicate to your hair, whether you're lazy or you're busy, or you know, you have a lot of time to actually dedicate to your hair. You need to figure all that out. You know, you need to figure out what kind of styles really match with your personality, because some people prefer, like I said, some people prefer to do low buns and high puffs. People like me will prefer cornrows, mini twists. Some other people might prefer braids, like box braids, knotless braids, right? And, you know, a lot of people demonize using extensions in your hair. Honestly, I think it's possible to grow your hair with extensions, but you just need to know how to do it, you know? And there are many videos out there. Even I have videos where I've explained how to take care of your hair in braids, how to take care of your hair in feeding cornrows, different hairstyles with different extensions. Honestly, I just feel like you just need to go through my YouTube channel. There are so many videos, but if you don't want to go through all that scrolling, just go ahead and ask any question that you have in the comments and I will give you like a link straight to the video that will explain everything to you, okay? So I'll meet you in the comments below. Even when I'm building a hair care routine for people, because I actually offer that as a service, a link in the description. These are some of the important questions that I ask my clients. I have them fill out a form, I hop on a call with them just so that I can find out as much as possible about them, their lifestyle, their relationship to their hair, the goals that they want to achieve, the problems, everything. I want to find out everything that I can so that I can create a routine for them that is not stressful for them to follow, but also helps them to hit those goals that they are trying to achieve. The icing on the cake is that I actually arrange that routine into a calendar form that they can print and paste on their wall so that it's easy for them to see it. It's easy for them to know exactly what they have to do per day. And that really helps with the consistency of my clients when it comes to following their routine. If you would like a personalized routine, you can hit the link in my pinned comment and we can get started. So that's it for this video, hun. I really hope that you have learned something today. Make sure you share this video with someone you think needs to see it so that we can help more women grow long and healthy hair. In the meantime, you can check either of these two videos, this one about dryness and this one about breakage. They are loaded with a lot of useful tips that I think you would enjoy. And I'll see you in my very next video. Until then, bye!